Trident Outdoors is proudly sponsored by Hamlin's Marine, Polar Craft Boats, Flambeau Outdoors, Yeti Coolers, Savage Drug.
Welcome back, everyone. I'm James Collins.
And I'm Christian Carlson.
And this is another episode of Trident Outdoors. Today's episode's really special to me because we're dragging you guys along to our annual guys fishing trip. Every spring in April, us five guys and the Trident crew sneak out to Lake Ontario. We trailer our 20-foot boat all the way from Bangor, Maine. It's a 600-mile ride one way, and you know you're going to have a few things happen every year. Big waves, bad weather, monster brown trout. There's a lot of bad attitudes on the boat by the end of the 4 days, but on the way home, it's nothing but hero stories. Stay tuned.
Hey guys, what are you up to?
Well, we're waiting to go fishing, but yeah. Somebody's showing up a little late.
I don't know what you're talking about. Good time.
Oh, and the good news is, boys, it's only 560 miles from here. Good time. Cash my check, claim my
truck. All right, boys, the first stop of the trip, Cabela's Scarborough, Maine.
As if five lanes of traffic wasn't enough, this was also the same weekend as the Boston Marathon tragedy, heightening tensions of travel. A place like Bass Pro is a dangerous place to be for a group of guys who are heading out for a much anticipated fishing trip. As soon as we got everything that we thought we needed and plenty more that we didn't need, we got a bite to eat and headed out on the road again. Tequila, beer on tap, sweet southern woman sit on my lap. G with an O, O with a D, T with an I and a M and a E and a good time. Good time. I've been working all week and I'm tired and I don't want to sleep and I want to have fun. Time for a good time. Oh, turn it up.
It's nearing midnight. Another hour and 20 minutes to go. Anybody else ready for nap time?
So we were running a little bit behind schedule and we didn't get to the motel until about 2 o'clock in the morning. We finally got there and the woman was asleep. There was a key left out on the counter, so we assumed it was ours and hoped for the best.
I've been driving for like 12 hours. I've snuck into somebody's room, which we assume is ours because they left us a key. And now, we need to transfer about 1,000 pounds of gear from the truck to the room and get our fishing line ready so we can go out and try to catch some steelhead in what's probably going to be like 2 hours from now. This will be a cute night.
Is so thin I can't even see it.
I know.
That, my friend, is exactly the point.
Right around that.
Thin.
Back off your drag a lot.
Maybe that's why it's so good, because we can't see it.
No one can see it, man.
Yeah, I know.
It's invisible. That's why we're using it. You're going from braid down to fluoro?
Yeah.
Huh?
No.
I guess maybe I have a little bit more confidence in the fluoro than he does, but I also try not to horse everything.
Are you saying that Matt's a little aggressive?
I'm saying that Matt may be a little bit overly aggressive. There may be a lesson in finesse that might come.
There's a possibility.
Matt is not known for
finesse.
So no, I'm running the same sort of egg bead situation as everybody else. The toothpicked trout.
So you got the bead 2 inches above your hook.
Right.
No knot through the bead. You just run your line through it, and
yeah,
then stuff a toothpick end through
right.
it. And then a number 6 or a number 8 circle octopus or
right.
whatever below
yep.
it.
I think it's a Gamagatsu, slightly turned in.
Gotcha.
Nice and sharp, razor sharp.
Excellent.
And a couple of larger split shot up the leader.
Yep.
And then some nice small split shot down the leader to just help that egg to float.
So there's been a lot of debate tonight on length of leader for steelhead.
Yeah.
What's your take? How much are you running right now?
I've got about 6 foot, probably.
6 feet of leader material?
Of leader material,
okay.
Yeah.
All right. Matt and I are on the short leader camp. I think both of us stretched a little long due to peer pressure. But anyway. Corey.
Yeah.
What are you swinging over there, old boy?
I'm going with the long leader too.
You are?
Yeah.
You running 6 pound?
Yeah, 6 pound fluoro, which I'm on Matt's camp. I'm not jumping. I think I'm gonna break a leader tomorrow.
I would say that personally I think it's pretty likely.
Yeah.
What's your first bait on, Corey? Are you gonna run a bead egg, or are you running one of those soft ones with the tail?
I'm running the bead with a toothpick.
Okay.
And when that breaks I can just throw one of the soft ones on my
Anybody want oatmeal?
Please.
Sweet. Oh, it appears as though it's getting warm.
Breakfast riverbank style.
That's right.
What's on the menu this morning, guys?
This is reconstituted fake oatmeal with fake strawberries and cream. All natural.
All natural.
Low
organic.
Calorie. Yep. We got it at the food co-op. What it is steelhead vitamin. We got a mix of oatmeal and power bait. Man. How's that untoasted bagel, Christian?
It'll do. It's gonna be steelhead power.
Steelhead power.
Are we going fishing or are we gonna eat breakfast all day?
If there happened to be a steelhead dance, what would a steelhead dance maybe entail? Right there. Right there.
Ready? Yep, yep.
Down.
Correct lifting motion. And up.
Oh.
This is a 30-pound steelhead lift.
So we knew the weather was going to be bad, but I don't think anybody realized how bad it actually was. The wind was keeping us off the lake, and so we said, let's go steelhead fishing. Well, they also had torrential downpours the week before, and the Salmon River was like 8 feet above flood stage. It was so bad that the flood had gone into the parking lot of the boat landing for the river. People were actually catching steelhead there. Check this out.
So look at their house.
Oh, fish.
I think their house is damp. The DA La Lodge is wet.
There's like...
Hey look, there's a fish cleaning station. The convenient part is you could actually fish from it.
These guys are fly fishing in the woods. That's kind of crazy.
What? There are people out there fishing?
People over here fishing. It's kind of
in the bubble line over here?
Yep. Two fish, three fish.
And then there's another one right here.
They're stacking.
Oh yeah, I see six right now. Unreal. One coming right out.
Here he is! Here he is! Silver, he's right there.
I know, if the line comes back over, I'll be over.
There you are, you're on him. Right beside you, bro.
Nope, before he reaches. There it
is. Excellent.
He's not a big one.
He'll do. Do the squat.
Yeah. Squat lifts.
Nice.
After 3 days of misery, a couple of grumpy guys really needed to catch some fish. Bad. Everybody was feeling it for sure. So the weather finally broke, and we were going to put the boat in the water.
Yeah, but that's when we found the boat landing. I'm telling you, it was bad. So the Salmon River, as Christian mentioned earlier, was between 8 and 10 feet high. Complete flood stage everywhere. So the boat landing is in the Salmon River. Unbelievable.
Stick around after the break to see how this unfolds.
So it's day three, we're getting some lines set out, we just got our gear out. It's been a really rough weekend so far. We've had absolutely everything from snow to sleet, rain, high winds, couldn't get on the lake one day. Very dangerous getting on the lake the next morning. So finally, we're on our last day. We don't even have a full day today. We're gonna just run it for a couple hours before we head home, and we'll see how it shakes out.
What are you running for baits right now, Christian?
Well, we're running a lot of Smithwick Rapala sort of baits and lures, something that looks like an alewife. We'll bait fish looking guys like that, silver and black.
Gotcha.
We've got some spoons out as well, in the same color pattern, silver and black, about the same size. I don't know, what is that, maybe 3 3/4, 4 inches, something like that. So that's what everybody's saying they're hitting on.
Fish on. Oh yeah. Hooked up.
Oh, this is a big fish.
Oh, that's a good fish.
Come on, stop fighting. Come on, baby.
Get there.
Here we go. There'll be a few more of those coming. Yep. Oh. Wait for him, Maddie. Wait for him. They got him. A lamprey on him. The whole time, that fish felt like it was getting ready to break the line.
The whole time.
That 16 or 18 pound test was some weak stuff. Get it out of there and get him in the cooler.
So what do you think, old boy?
Oh, well, I'm going to tell you that if you want to price him per pound, it's not worthwhile. But emotionally speaking, I'm going to tell you what, man. I've never worked so hard to put fish in the boat in my life. And this really does make it all worth it. This is pretty spectacular. And I could not have brought a better crew of people Look at this thing.
That thing's awesome.
Oh, yeah. Man.
Nice fish.
It's going to be a good 8 pounds.
Let's do it again.
We're coming.
Fire him out, bud.
I can see him.
Yep. That's a nice one, bud. That's a nice one. You got perfect rod angle. Everything looks great. Just let that fish wear out. Rod this way. Rod this way. Don't pull back. Just rod over.
Got him.
That's a nice one.
Yes, boys.
That's the big one that we're looking for.
Holy crap!
Good job. Good work, Christian. Good work.
So this is what we came for. 9 pounds. How many inches do we know?
22.
22. Just like football. It's fat. Fat, fat. Got a nail wedge out of its mouth as soon as we got it in the boat. I'm excited. This is what we came for.
Don't give him much more drag, bro. You're going to want to let him run if he needs to run. It's going to be a 10 or 15 minute deal. He won't go anywhere. I know. That's what the big ones do, bro. Two fish that same pole in 10 minutes. That fish is taking the planer down.
There was a planer on this?
Yeah.
Pardon the time, Justin.
Yep. No, he's just staying down, bro. You haven't worn this fish out yet. He's got another 5 minutes in.
I just saw him, Corey.
That's a monster, Corey.
There he is, coming up top, yeah.
He's got that planer board underwater, bro.
Look at him run.
He can swim with that planer board. Matt, blink neutral just for a second. All right, now kick it back in. Holy cow, look at that. That's the only way we're going to get headway with this fish. This is a beast. We're all shaking, bro.
Yeah.
Corey, gentle, same angle.
Get him in the boat, get him in the boat. The hook's out of his mouth.
I got the shakes. He's yours, Corey. Holy crap, he said that was the only way to hook that.
Color on him.
Oh, bonehead.
Yeah.
Day 3 of misery.
Yeah.
Finally, we got some
weather. It's been a rough
stretch,
man.
You got the big fish.
Yeah.
So, what were you thinking when that started to go down?
I was just afraid of losing the darn thing. Just trying to keep my tip up, keep pressure on the line.
10 minute plus fight, yeah. Guys. That was a 10 or 15 minute fish. Easy, easy. But it was worth it, wasn't it?
Oh, holy cow, absolutely.
So it's my first time out on Lake Ontario. Definitely have a new respect for the lake after being out here a couple of days. Getting tossed around the first day, couldn't even get out on it the second day. Probably shouldn't have been out on the morning of this third day. It's been a little crazy. Definitely got to have respect for the water and respect for what's going on around you. But slow, definitely slow fishing, but now that we've caught some fish and got some fish in the boat, it definitely changed the mood of the group and changed the mood of everything. Went from being what was going to be a very long and arduous ride home to a backslapping good time, joking around time riding home. It's definitely turned out to be one of the best fishing trips I've ever been on. Thank you to everybody involved, especially thank you to the good Lord above for blessing us with this gift that he's given us.
From all of us here at Trident Outdoors, thanks for joining us on Lake Ontario in 2013.
What a great trip, guys. Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thank you, guys.